When you're on a
holiday. Step one. What you want to do is make sure you have all the necessary items that you need for clamming. We keep ours in the clam closet. You need a clam rake, a bucket, a set of boots, and of course, your sense of humor. You also need, in the state of South Carolina, a fishing license, so don't forget before you get on the beach. Step two, you need to make sure you find the perfect beach for your clamming. We choose Mitchellville Beach Park. It's great. It's adopted by the Hilton Head High School Science Department. Then what you want to do is unload the car and get ready to go. Remember, no disturbing the peace. This one's for you, Dad. Step three, you want to pick the perfect spot on the beach for your clamming. What you usually want to do is start out somewhere and just see if you get one within the next couple strokes, and look! If you do, then you found a good spot. Continue your raking and hopefully you find lots more. Step four of clamming. What you want to do is check out all the clams that you spent all that hard time getting. Be careful going through the mud, it can get quite deep at places. Judging by the notch nicked into the end of your bucket, you can judge whether it's the inch across that you need. Make sure you check all of them. You also want to make sure you have more clams than anybody else. Then when it comes to dinner time, you get to eat the most too. Step five, after all that hard work, who doesn't need a little bit of a rest on the beach? But don't make it too long. It's time to carry all those clams back to the car. Woo! Nothing like that. It's a long way. Step six. During step six, what we do is we rinse all the clams that we just got to get all that muck off of them. We also rinse our legs and our shoes before getting back in the car. During this time, we also count all the clams to see how many we got. Step seven of our clamming. Well, as you can see, this step is missing because it's eating, and that's what we're doing right now. Hope you enjoyed.